Okay, good afternoon everyone.
Good afternoon.
Welcome back to Social Science class. And this class is for political science. Okay, so for only 9 students here. Others will join soon, I think so. Okay, anyway, we will start the session. Okay, so listen everyone. So last class we discussed about the gender discrimination in India, right? Clear? It's international trouble, right? Everywhere, in almost all the countries, we are able to find this problem, what gender discrimination. Okay, we discussed about the gender discrimination, or a number of questions related with the gender discrimination and how to eradicate the problem. Okay, how to solve the problem of gender discrimination. And we studied about the feminism, feminist movements, and the role of women in the politics, in politics. Okay, this kind of things completed. And we started religion and the connection between religion and politics. Religion and politics, that is our topic today. Okay, we want to discuss about the religion and its relation with the politics, or role of religion in politics. Okay, this is the main point for us today. And one more thing, it is called to be communalism. Communalism, right? Communalism, communal violences. And what is communalism and impact of communalism on society? Okay, so negative impact of communalism on the society. That all the, that are the things that one would discuss, that what we want to discuss today. Okay, so before that, everyone take your notes. Okay, there is no interest for you people, I think, to listen the class. Okay, so first 10 minutes, you write the notes and we will start the class. Okay, all of you, well, you 2 minutes to take your notes and a pen. Okay, notes in the sense, you are writing on paper and filing that, right? So take materials to write the notes. All of you, take it. Turn on your cameras. Aditya, Pratyush, Haya, Bhadra, Vishnupriya, Fia, Hadedi, Asya, Haya, sorry, Haya. Please turn on your cameras. So listen, so far, just small request to Hadedi Rasya. Please turn on your camera. Okay. I'm unable to recognize you. Please turn on your camera. The last several classes I intimated you to turn on your camera, but you are not ready to do that. Hadedi, so that's what the pronunciation, right? Rasya, see, no connection, no answers, no reply. Better, definitely, okay, I will remove you from the class. So just give some reply, or at least to turn on your camera. No reply. No reply. If any reason, you can inform me. Ah, now I have. Hello, can you hear me? Hello. Okay, fine. So definitely I will report that. So this start writing. Religion, communalism, and politics. Religion, communalism, and politics.
Sir, what should we write? Will you say one more time?
This is just notes only related with the communalism and religion. Write the heading. Religion, communalism, and politics. Communalism and politics. So write down the heading. Religion, communalism. CUMMUNALISM, communalism, religion, communalism, and religion, communalism, and politics. Okay, the first point, Indian democracy
Sir, we have written this.
Melvin Martin.
Sir, we have written this.
Just read that statement.
Indian democracy faced the problem of capitalism, communism, literacy, and
non-formal. Okay. So how many points? Tell me the last point.
The use of religion in politics is known as communal politics.
The use of religion in politics is known as communal politics. Good. Okay. So continue that, Margaret. Okay. Continue. Next point. Ideas. Ideas. Will you mute your mic? Ideas. Ideas. So continuation only. Ideas. Ideals. I-D-E-A-L-S. Ideals. And values. And values, drawn from different religions, can and perhaps ideas, ideals, and values drawn from different religions can and perhaps should play a role in politics. Okay, so values of religion or values from the different religions, ideas from different religions, ideals from different religions can play a role in politics. Next point, people should be able to express in politics, people, they are able to express in politics their needs. So in politics, people will express their needs, comma, interests, comma, demands as a member of a religious community. Okay, so in a country like India, we know that there are number of religions are there. At the same time, number of political parties also are there in the country, right? Okay, we are the members of one religion. Our interests, our needs, our demands, we are expressing in politics. Okay, at what time? No problem. Okay, clear? So first of all, you want to understand we are the part of one religion. Okay, so this kind of demands that expressing by an individual in one country. Okay, so want to understand one thing, we are the part of one religion. So we are expressing all these things as a part of the religion. Okay, next point. Communal politics is based on the idea that religion is the principal basis of communal politics. Politics on the basis of religion or communal principles. Right on. Communal politics is based on the idea that the religion is the principal basis of social community. Principal basis of a social community. Clear? So that is the belief. What is that? Okay. So one particular religion, okay, they are able to render their vote for one particular political party. That party is able to hold power in the government. Okay. So that particular political party always will support that religion. Okay, and that religion will try to dominate over other religions. It is not good at all. Okay, next one. Communalism can take various forms in politics. Next heading. Communalism can take place. Various forms. In politics. Heading, underline. First point.
Sir, can you tell again?
Repeating, communalism can take various forms in politics. communalism can take various forms in politics. First point. The most common expression of communalism, the most common expression of communalism is in everyday belief. Second point. A communal mind often leads to a quest for political dominance. Political dominance of dominance, D-O-M-I-N-A-N-C-E. Political dominance. Write down. Once on religious community. Only told you that, please keep your cameras on. No one is doing that, remember. Okay, next point. Political mobilization on religious lines is another form of communalism. Political mobilization on religious lines is another form of communalism. Next point. Communalism takes its most ugly form of communal violence. Ugly form of communal violence. Comma, rights, R-I-O-T-S, rights. Rights, communal violence, comma, rights, and massacre. M-A-S-S-A-R-A-C-R-E, massacre. Massacre means? What is massacre?
Rule.
Mass killing.
Of course, mass killing. Okay. So already studied that in history, the Jallianwala Bagh massacre, right? Okay, remember, connect all those things there. Okay, fine. So that's about communism can take various forms in politics. Next one, secularism. Next heading, secularism. S-E-C-U-L-A-R. Secularism. Okay. Write down. In a secular state like India, there is no official religion for the state. There is no official religion for the state. Okay, second point. In a secular state like India, there is no official religion for the state. Second point says, the constitution provides to all individuals to all individuals and communities, all individuals and communities, freedom to press, sorry, freedom of profess, not press, profess, P-R-O-F-E-S-S, profess, comma, practice, and propagate any religion. So these three words are important: profess, practice, and propagate. P-R-O-F-E-S-S, P-R-A-C-T-I-S-E, practice, that's one, propagate, P-R-O-P-A-G-A-T, propagate any religion, comma, or not to follow any. Okay.
Sir, no.
Or not to follow any religion. That's what. Not to follow any religion. Next line. Write down. Some of its features are, features of the Indian Constitution, right? Features are, first of all, the Constitution prohibits discrimination on the grounds of religion. The Constitution prohibits discrimination on the grounds of religion. On the grounds of religion. Second point. At the same time, the Constitution allows the state to intervene, I-N-T-E-R-V-E-N-E, intervene in the matters of religion, in order to ensure equality within religious communities. Okay, done?
Yes, sir.
Within religious communities.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now open your textbook.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so file that. Okay. So notes that related with communalism and the role of communalism in politics and secular state. Now we will discuss that from the textbook here.
Sir.
Yeah, tell me.
I am not able to on my video. If I on my video, I cannot hear anything.
Okay, fine. So just keep that off. No problem.
Yes, sir.
Number of cameras are off. You have some genuine reason. Okay, fine. Otherwise, it is important. Please keep your cameras on. Okay. So we are here. Communalism. Right? Okay. So observe here. What do you mean by the term communalism? I already told you people that communalism. Okay. So, thinking that one's religion is greater than others, a prejudiced attitude towards other religions. Okay. And making harm, creating trouble in the society on the basis of religion. That's what communalism. Okay. So, we are here. The problem begins with religion is seen as the basis of the nation. So, one individual or a group of people or a society is thinking that the religion is the basis of one nation, there the problem starts. The example of Northern Ireland that we discussed already, sorry, not discussed because we not completed this chapter. Okay, It is actually omitted from the syllabus. Let it be. Okay. And the dangers of such approach to nationalism. So if you're thinking that one's religion is greater than others and your religion is the backbone of the country, okay, particular nation, that all will create a problem in the society. Okay. So we are here. Just leave all this area. When one religion and its followers are pitted against other, so you are acting badly against other religion or creating trouble to other religion. Okay, this happens when beliefs of one religion are presented as superior to those of other religion. So one person or one individual or one community or one society thinking that our religion is the greater one than the others. Okay, definitely such kind of thinking or belief will lead to number of problems in the society. When the demands of one religious group are formed in opposition to another, and when state power is used to establish domination of one religious group over the rest, this manner of using religion politics is a communal politics. Okay, so one particular religion, they are the people basically supporting the government, and the government also providing support for that particular religion, but not for other religions. Okay, for example, one religion is the majority religion in one country. Just imagine, one religion is the majority religion in one country. All other religions are minorities, right? Yes or no? Yes or no? In terms of population, number of people, those who believe in that particular religion, okay, we are able to assume that that one particular religion is the major religion related with the number of people, those who believe in that. Clear? Okay. So other all religions are termed as what? Minorities. They are minorities. Okay. And basically the political parties will gain votes from this majority religion to hold power in the government or make the government. Imagine. Clear? So basically that government will support that majority religion, right? Yes or no? Yes or no?
Yes,
sir. What is your answer? If they are supporting the majority religion, the government supporting the majority religion, the minorities feel they are alienated, right?
Yes, sir.
Made them away from the mainstream of the society. They will feel like that, right? So there is a clash emerge, or there is a tension emerged between the majority and the minority. What happened, Aditya? Aditya Nair is smiling, laughing, enjoying the class. A class or something else, I don't know. Is the chat is on or off here? That is off. Tell me, Aditya, what is going on? Sending messages? We have special class groups for the friends and relatives. Okay, listen carefully. Listen carefully. So the minorities will believe that they are alienated. Okay, they are away from the mainstream of the society. It will create a tension between the majority and the minorities, right? Okay, so if government supporting a particular religion, definitely it will lead to a civil war in the country. A tension between the majority and the minorities. We already studied that in the case of Sri Lanka. Clear? Yes or no? In Sri Lanka, what happened? Can you tell me what happened in Sri Lanka? The case study from the chapter number 1. Power sharing. Tell me, Steve, what happened in Sri Lanka? What is the reason for the civil war in Sri Lanka?
Majorityism.
Majorityism. Majoritarianism. Okay. So what happened there?
The leaders, Buddhist leaders, were not sensitive to the feelings of the Tamil Indians. So there was a feeling of discrimination.
Okay, so government basically supported. Okay, government supported the Sinhala language and the religion Buddhism. Okay, and the Tamil-speaking Hindus and Muslims, they felt they are alienated. Okay, because of that, the tension arose in Sri Lanka. Clear? Clear or not? That's what the Sri Lankan issue that we studied already in chapter number 1. Yeah, tell me, Melvin.
No, yes, sir.
Ah, you told yes, sir. Okay, sir. Thank you. Okay, so here, communal politics is based on the idea that religion is the principal basis of social community. Okay, so communal politics is based on the idea that religion is the principal basis of social community. Okay, so this kind of communal crisis or communalism is the result of, okay, the result means this kind of thinking is arising in a one society because the people, they believe that, or their belief is nothing but their religion is the base of the society. If their religion is not there, there is no existence for the country. They'll think like that. Okay, so communalism involves thinking along the following lines. The followers of a particular religion must belong to one community. Okay, so the people, those who thinking on the lines or religious lines, the thinking is related with the religious lines, they will think that communalism involves thinking along the following lines. The followers of the particular religion must belong to one community. Clear? The people, those who believe in they believe in one single religion, they should live together, it seems. Okay, their fundamental interests are the same. They are saying that the people, those who belong in one religion, their ideas, their interests are the same, it seems. What is your answer? The people, those who thinking in this communal line or religious lines, they say that the people, those who believing in one religion, want to live together, okay, in one single locality. Clear? And they stated that,
yes,
the people, those who believe in one religion, they have same interest, same ideas. Is that correct? Same,
no,
likes,
sir.
And dislikes. Is that correct?
No, sir.
No.
Not at all. Okay.
No.
So you people are thinking rationally, which means something is there inside your head. Okay. Rational thinking. Very good it is. Okay. So we know that. Okay. All individuals are not the same, not thinking as same. Okay. Their ideas are different. Okay, so any different that they may have is irrelevant or trivial for the community life. Clear? So if any other thinking is there, any other difference is there, it is irrelevant, it seems. They are not taking care of that, it seems. Okay, it also follows that people who follow different religion cannot belong to a same social community. Okay, and the people, those who thinking in the religious land, they're stating that different religions cannot belong to a same social society. The people, those who believe in different religion, cannot live together in a particular geographical locality. Okay, is that idea clear? What is,
yes,
your answer? What is your answer? Is this statement is correct or not?
Yes.
The statement is, people, those who believe in different religion, cannot live in a single geographical unit. Cannot live together, it seems. What is your answer? What is your answer?
No, sir.
No, sir. Okay. We are able to live together, right? Whatever the religion, we are living together, right or not? In a single society. The same society we are living. Okay. So, the answer is wrong. Okay. So here you can see, if the followers of different religion have some commonalities, these are superficial and immaterial. Okay, superficial means true. Okay, and immaterial. What do you mean immaterial? Something that related with the religion. Okay, spiritual, immaterial, spiritual. Okay, if the followers of different religion have some commonalities, these are superficial and immaterial, these interests are bound to be different and involve a conflict. Okay, so we know that if one person who believes in one religion, his neighbor who believes in another religion, and they are living in the single society or same society, sometimes it will lead to some tension or conflict. In its extreme form of communalism, leads to the belief that people belonging to the different religions cannot live as equal citizens within one nation. So, the extreme belief of a person, those who thinking in a communal line or a religious line, he or she stating that, Okay, what is that? People belonging to different region cannot live as equal citizen within one nation. Okay, the people, those who belong to different religion, cannot lead a good life or cannot enjoy equality in one nation. Okay, the extreme thinking. Either one of them has to dominate the rest, or they have to form different nation. So, if different types of people or of the people with different religious viewpoints living together in one locality, okay, the majority religion will dominate over the minority, or the minorities wanted to create a separate nation. It's clear? Problem. They're telling about some problems here. Okay, what is that? The majority will dominate over the minority, or the minority will create a separate nation. Separate nations, it seems. Okay, so just read. Just read 2 minutes. The people, those who thinking on the religious line or communal line, they are against the minorities. Okay, such kind of people, they are always trying to dominate over the minorities. Clear? Anyway, they are the part of the majority, we know that. Your minorities will not think like this. Okay, the majority people. Okay, and the finally they stated that, what is that? In a country, there are people, those who believe in different religion, the majority will dominate over the minority, or the minority wanted to create their own nation, or they want to separate from that country and want to create another nation, it seems. Is that correct? You got that point, right?
Yes, okay. Sir. Okay,
so please check in your notes also. We are moving forward. Here it is. This belief is fundamentally flawed. It is wrong. People of one religion do not have the same interest and aspiration in every context. Correct. We already discussed that. People in one religion do not have the same interest and aspiration in every context. Okay. Everyone has several other roles, positions, and identities in one society. Clear? Every individual has several other roles in the society. Okay, position in the society, identities in the society. So their thinking is not the same. Okay, their aspirations are not the same. Okay, there are many voices inside every community. Many voices, many different opinions will be there from the same community or from the same religion. All these voices have the right to be heard. So we want to hear all these voices, all these opinions. Therefore, any attempt to bring all followers of one religion together in context other than religion is bound to suppress many voices within the community. So, if the religious leaders want to bring all these people under the strict control of the religion, it is not that easy. They want to do so, they have to suppress many voices. What do we suppress? What is that? They have to control. They have to block, clear, the voices of many people, many others basically. Clear? Okay. Next one. Communalism can take place various forms in politics. Communalism can take place various forms in politics. Relationship between the communalism and politics. Here you can see. The most common expression of communalism is an everyday belief. This routinely involve religious prejudices, stereotypes, and religious communities, and belief in the superiority of one religion over the other religion. Superiority, okay, of one religion over the other religion. This is so common that we often fail to notice it even when we believe in it. Okay, so we can see here. So communalism is in everyday beliefs. Okay, so different people, they're believing in different religions. Okay, these routinely involve religious prejudices. So you can see, the people from one religion, they always think that their religion is superior than the other religion. Superior than the other religions. Clear? So listen, I already told you that this is the theoretical part. It is not that easy to understand. You want to read it again. Okay, clear. Again, yes, doubts are there, you have to inform me. Okay, so here, this routinely involved religious prejudices and stereotypes of religious communities and beliefs in the superiority of one's religion over other religions. Okay, they are always thinking that our religion is the finest religion. Okay, so it is our responsibility to support one political party and hold power in the government. Okay, then the government will support them and they are able to dominate over the other religion. Okay, so simple meaning. Next one, the communal mind often leads to a quest of political dominance. We discussed that, right? Okay, a communal mind, a person who is thinking related with his own religion or her own religion, they always want power. For those belonging to the majority community, this takes the form of majoritarian dominance. Okay, they want power and they want to dominate over the minority. For those belonging to the minority community, it can take the form of a desire to form a separate political unit. Okay, so majority will decide or majority will think that, okay, they are able to dominate over the minorities and they will try to do so. The same time, minority people, the minorities will think that they are alienated. Okay, they want to create a separate country. Clear? A separate political unit. So 2 points. Thirdly, political mobilization. Okay, so mobilization means what is that? Making group of people for one particular activity is termed as mobilization. On religious lines of making organization, creating organization. Okay, and political mobilization on religious lines is another frequent form of communalism. Okay, means collecting or creating organization with masses, number of people. That's what mobilization. Okay, on the religious line. So they made or creating this organization on the basis of religion. And the people, those who participating in that organization from one particular religion, is another form of communalism. Another form of communalism. Such organizations will create troubles in the society. Troubles in the society. Sometimes you might heard about terrorist groups. Clear? Okay, such kind of organizations. Clear? Okay, so that groups formed on the basis of religion and creating trouble to another religions. This involved the use of sacred symbols. So this kind of organizations, basically they will use sacred symbols, symbols of one particular religion. Religious leaders, okay, emotional appeal and plain fear in order to bring the followers to one religion together in a political arena. So sometimes, not only these terrorist groups, some political parties also formed on the basis of religion, right? So these political parties also will use these sacred symbols. Leaders, political leaders, to mobilize the people from the same religion. From the same religion. Okay, clear? They will say that you are belong to this religion and this party's leaders also from the same religion. So it is your responsibility to participate or take a membership in this political party. Because your leader told, okay, this party is our party, our religion's party. Okay. Political party. Okay. In electoral politics, this often involves special appeal to the interest of emotions of voters of one religion in preference to others. Okay. So almost all the political parties using this technique. Okay. The political party leaders will visit the leaders of different religions, or different caste group to ensure or make sure the votes. Clear. Make sure that their followers are providing vote for that particular political party. Okay, so all political parties are doing the same. Sometimes communalism takes place is most ugly form of communal violence, rights and massacre. Rights and massacre. So you don't want to write this entire things as the answer for the question. Write a short note on what? What? The role of religion in politics. Okay. Yes, sometimes communalism takes its most ugly form of communal violence, rights and massacre. Okay, so rights means what? Conflict, fight between the religions, massacre, mass killing of people. India and Pakistan suffered some of the worst communal rights at the time of the partition. India and Pakistan, we faced that problem. Okay, at the time of partition in the year 1947. Okay, in that religious rights, okay, number of people died. Okay, this 1947. So just give me 1 minute. Okay. So the post-independence period has also seen large-scale communal violence. So after independence also, in India, there are number of riots, basically termed as the communal violence. Okay. So write the question. Write the question. Communism can take various forms in politics, right? Communism can take various form in politics. Various forms in politics. Explain. Communism can take place various forms in politics. Explain. So please check your notes. You already wrote the answer. Clear? Okay. So that is only for 3 mark.
Sir, will you repeat the question?
Okay, write down. Communalism can take place various forms in politics. Various forms in politics. Explain. You can see here, page number 47. Communalism can take place various forms in politics. Explain. So you can see here, 1, 2, 3. 3 paragraphs are there. It is the answer of basically from your textbook. And you please check your notes. Answer is there. A short answer is there, right? Okay, you can write that for 5 mark also.
Yes, sir.
No problem.
Yes, sir.
All the points are there. Hope you got the meaning of those points after this discussion. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So please learn from your notes. Most of the points are there. Almost all the points are there. Okay. So please learn it. Okay. So what is the question? What is the question? It's a 5 mark. Or ask definitely it will ask for 5 mark or at least for 3 mark. Okay. Communism can take various forms in politics. Explain. Okay. Okay, yes, and it's time to wind up the session. So we will meet in the next class. Okay, thank you. Thank you very much. So to next class, we'll discuss about secularism or secular state. Thank you.